This video is going to cover objective 2.4 practice tasks. The first step asks you to select the fields in the customer's table. You're going to double click and open it in data sheet view. And you can hover over company name. You're going to get a little black down arrow. And either you can left click and go right across, or you can click company name, hold down shift, and then click the other two fields. We have company name, and contact title. And we're going to create a quick start data type named contact basics. So we're going to go to the Fields tab, we're going to go into More Fields, go all the way down to where it says Save Selection as New Data Type, and we're going to type in Contact Basics. Then we're going to go ahead and hit OK. Then we're going to hit OK again if that pops up. And we're going to close out of the Customers table and go to Create, and we're going to create a new table in Design View. So you're going to click on Table Design. And right off the bat, we are going to type in our first field, which is going to be contact ID. And then we are going to choose a data type of auto number and a primary key. So we're going to hit save, and we're saving the table as contacts. I have one that already exists, so I'm just going to replace the one I have because I was already going through the project. And then we're going to go into data sheet view. So once we're in data sheet view, we are going to add the contact basics data type application part. So we're going to go up to fields, go into more fields, scroll down to the bottom. You're going to click on that contact basics data type part. Then the next step is going to have us hit Control S. And we're going to close out of this table, contacts table. Then from there, we're going to open the order details table in design view. And it wants us to create a rule that for the quantity field, amounts entered must be less than 100. So you're just going to go to the quantity field. Down here is we're going to enter that validation rule. And you're going to type in less than 100. So you're shift comma and then 100. If the rule is violated, you are going to type in the validation text to appear. Order quantities of 100 or more require approval. Then from there, it wants you to test the rule. So, let's go ahead and put a period in. Then let's go to data sheet view. Hit yes, do you want to save it? Yes, yes one more time. And basically you're going to go up to quantity here. You're going to take this out, type in 101. Since that's higher than 100, when you hit the down arrow, it automatically pops up, gives you the error message, order of quantities of more than one of 100 or more require approval. So we're going to hit OK. Then we're going to take that out, put 12 back in. And then now you can move about the rest of the table without any errors. Then we're going to go to the employees table, and we're going to use the name and caption command to update the caption property for the courtesy field so it reads title of courtesy. So we're going to right click on the employees table. We're going to go to courtesy. Caption is down here. It says courtesy. And we're just going to type in title of courtesy. So hit Control S to save that. And then in design view, and this actually says use the name and caption command. So if you weren't using it in design view, if you go into data sheet view and go to fields, here's the name and caption command. So you could do it here too. Either way, and that's on employee ID, so it's not showing right. If you click on title of courtesy, name and caption, then here's where you could change it if you were on that specific field. So you can do it either way, whether you're in design view or data sheet view, it doesn't matter. Then we're going to change the format of the birth date field to long date. So we're going to go into design view, birth date field, format here. You're going to click the drop down menu and you're going to choose long date. Then create an input mask for the higher date field that uses a medium date format. So you're just going to click on the higher date field, click down here where it says input mask. Click on the three little dots on the right. That's your expression button. Yes, you're going to save the table and medium date. Next, and then just hit finish. So now you have an input mask if you go to add that date into the table. This completes objective 2.4 practice tasks.